good afternoon. For those who are new, I'm Dr. Theron Sherman, and today we will be studying SCP-WCPGW-J. There isn't any objectionable material in this document, so let's begin. Item number, SCP-WCPGW-J. Object class, Apollyon. Correction, safe. Special containment procedures. Foundation personnel found exhibiting SCP-WCPGW-J are allowed to continue their duties after reporting to psychiatric staff. Personnel are encouraged to describe and record various scenarios described by SCP-WCPGW-J in case it becomes useful, but such an occasion has yet to come. Psychiatric staff treating SCP-WCPGW-J are encouraged to use the official response listed in the addendum below. As SCP-WCPGW-J exhibits no compulsion, thaumaturgical, alchemical, mimetic, antimimetic, or achromatic effects, no one should have their performance affected by SCP-WCPGW-J. Personnel found exhibiting SCP-WCPGW-J should be monitored for attempts to access files above their clearance. Foundation personnel should not use SCP-WCPGW-J as an excuse for infractions committed. Description. SCP-WCPGW-J is an anomalous state of mind that typically affects researchers with clearance level 1, mainly many new or junior researchers or other assistants, working on SAFE or Euclid-class SCPs. SCP-WCPGW-J comes in the form of a shared delusion of the perceived risk of the SAFE or Euclid objects, which includes outlandish hypotheticals that go beyond the capabilities of those anomalies. Many of these shared delusions include having complex situations of how an object, often inanimate, would breach containment, its level of risk and possibility of containment breach, including inducing certain K-class scenarios. While some safer Euclid SCPs do pose danger when exposed to the general public, SCP-WCPGW-J delusions often take hold onto surreal and improbable hypothetical situations that would not occur in accordance to the current consensus reality and scientific understandings. The vast majority of SAFE and Euclid anomalies are not at risk, nor have ever been at risk of containment breach, much less a K-class scenario. Regardless, many suffering from SCP-WCPGW-J believe the anomaly to be much more nefarious than presented, and often request the object be reclassified as Keter, or request immediate destruction. SCP-WCPGW-J delusions have not ever been observed. SCP-WCPGW-J is easily combated. In addition to the official responses, research found that certain phrases of mockery have proven to be useful in mitigating the effects of SCP-WCPGW-J. Some examples include, "That sounds too crazy to be true."
"I don't think so."
"Are you okay?"
"Do you hear what you're saying?"
"Please see a doctor. A regular one." Addendum. An incomplete log of SCP-WCPGW-J occurrences. Official responses are encouraged to be used, but regular mockery works best to fight SCP-WCPGW-J in most cases. The following table lists SCP, SCP-WCPGW-J Delusion. Official response. SCP-3900.
Delusion.
A pervasive worry of SCP-3900 connecting to the wider internet and causing major cities to be overrun with wolves.
Official response.
The wolves demanifest after the full moon. SCP-1999.
Delusion.
A containment breach leading to PK-class end-of-narrative scenario where the written word is overtaken by SCP-1999.
Official response.
No such scenario. SCP-2960.
Delusion.
A potential containment breach leading to an SK-class All the World's a Stage scenario where the entire world is forced to perform Urinetown.
Official response.
No such scenario. SCP-500.
Delusion.
Being found leaking into the waters after a potential containment breach, to eventually lead to an Omega K-class end-of-death scenario. Shared images from delusions include brain transplantations and a large crucible.
Official response.
No such scenario. SCP-3183.
Delusion.
Breach would cause MK-class end-of-human consciousness scenario.
Official response.
There would be one if anyone can decipher the file. SCP-348.
Delusion.
a pervasive worry that they are disappointing their father, leading to the anomalous production of excess salt water from SCP-348, leading to an NK-class gray goo scenario.
Official response.
Reassurance that their father does not remember them after being amnesticized as part of Foundation Protocol. SCP-173.
Delusion.
A truly strange amount of emphasis has surrounded a relatively mundane anomaly, including multiplying somehow and through a series of containment breaches, taking over Site-19 and eventually the entirety of North America. SCP-173 assignment was a punishment for infractions, capable of love and reproduction. Something called Fiesta Mode.
Official response.
SCP-173 is exactly as written. SCP-2615-J.
Delusion.
That the -J class designation was a mistake.
Official response.
SCP-2615-J is exactly as written. SCP-999.
Delusion.
A widespread delusion regarding SCP-999 as the child of the Scarlet King, particularly that it is the result of intentional abatement of Procedure 110 Montauk. Footnote: how Level 1 personnel have widespread awareness of the existence of SCP-231-7, Procedure 110 Montauk, or the Scarlet King, is currently under investigation.
Official response.
Nope. SCP-1370.
Delusion.
SCP-1370 is the Broken God.
Official response.
The Church would be very insulted. SCP-765.
Delusion.
An inverted instance of SCP-WCPGW-J. Many irrationally claim that SCP-765 is not anomalous, and is merely a very relaxing spot for Foundation personnel.
Official response.
There are no ducks here at this pond. SCP-__J.
Delusion.
Widespread laziness leading to the end of the world.
Official response.
Already happening anyways without anomalous influence.